Welcome, friends, to another episode of our summer home church for kids, where we get to hear a great story about Jesus today. But before doing that, let's spend some time worshiping God together and praising Him. Are you ready to sing, dance, and shout together? Let's go!
My Jesus knows my name. When I'm sleeping or awake, no matter what I do, He'll never leave, His words are true. I tell Him what I love. I tell Him when I'm scared. I tell Him everything. Jesus is always there. I'm spinning round, I'm running free. I'm having fun, yeah, with my King. No one is like You, Jesus. No one like You. Jesus, that's You. My Jesus knows my name. When I'm sleeping or awake, no matter what I do, He'll never leave, His words are true. I tell Him what I love. I tell Him when I am scared. I tell Him everything. Jesus is always there. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF. That's You. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF. That's You.
we have a new verse. This says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. From Proverbs 3:5. All right, I'll show you the motions and then you do it with me. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Proverbs 3:5. Let's try it again. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Proverbs 3:5. Great job, friends.
Hi, Promised Land friends. I'm Grandma Julie. And with me today, I have some special friends to do our WhatsApp box. These are my grandchildren, Daniel, Lucille, and Juliana. And since Daniel and Lucille are a fusion, they're going to sit out in the audience and help make some good guesses to determine what's in the box. And since Juliana's in Promised Land, she's going to help with the WhatsApp box, okay? All right, you want to get it out of here? Yes! There you go. All right, careful, nice job. Now, why don't you hop up on that stool? And Graham will come around behind you. And are you ready to sneak a peek?
Yeah.
Okay, let's sneak a peek and see what's in there.
Wow, do you know what's in there?
Right. She knows. She's ready. Can you give them a clue? How about what color it is again?
It's blue.
Okay, can
water?
You?
Actually,
what? What did he say?
Water.
Is it water?
Yeah.
Wow, was that fast? Why don't you show him? It is indeed. It's water. I wonder, how do we use water? Use it to drink?
Yeah.
Do we use it for anything else? What else do we use
to
it
wash
for?
Wash our hands. Water our plants.
Water our plants. Lots of these were things we use water for. But I wonder what it's going to have to do with our big God story. So what comes next?
The big God story.
Thank you.
Of the Bible. Peter walks on water. This is Peter.
Hey-o!
Whoop. Peter was a fisherman who was called by Jesus.
Hey!
Peter saw the many miracles of Jesus.
Wow!
And he heard all his teachings. Great crowds followed Jesus wherever he went. One day after Jesus had done a great miracle, he sent the disciples in a boat across the lake while he stayed and sent the people home.
See ya!
Hey, Jesus!
After sending them home, Jesus went up into the hills by himself to pray. Meanwhile, the disciples were in trouble far away from land, for a strong wind had risen and they were fighting heavy waves. About 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came toward them, walking on water. When the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified.
Ah!
In their fear, they cried out, "It's a ghost!"
Hold on there.
But Jesus spoke to them at once. "Don't be afraid," he said. "Take courage. I am here." Then Peter called to him, "Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water." So Jesus said, "Yes, come." So Peter went over the side of the boat.
Whoa, you're awesome.
And walked on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and began to sink.
"Peter, help me!"
"Save me, Lord," he shouted. Jesus immediately reached out and grabbed him. Jesus said, "You have so little faith. Why did you doubt me?" When they climbed back into the boat, the wind stopped. Then the disciples worshiped him and said, "You really are the Son of God."
Because Jesus is God, he is mighty and powerful. God loves you, and you belong to him. He is always near to you, and you can trust him. That truth makes me want to worship him. When we worship God, we get to show and tell him just how we feel about him. Whether we stand, or we sit, or we lift our arms, or we kneel, these are all ways that we can show God with our bodies and worship him. Friends, God is always near to us, no matter what. He loves us and he cares for us. God loves you and you are his children. He chooses to be near you always. You can always trust him. Thanks for joining us today, friends. We'll see you next time.